Good morning. Gilbert, can you put your hand out like that? Okay, see how big those hands are? We're going to need to have exercises for you so your hands get bigger so you can hold more money in there. I'm going to tell you a story this morning about friendships and anger. Do you think the two go together?
No.
Nope.
No. If there's no me, there's no I in team.
Very good.
There's no I in team.
Okay, so listen. I'm going to tell you a story about Trevor, Andy, and Chad. They were all friends. Trevor was my son. Okay? And, he still is. Well, because this happened like a long time ago, because he was younger than anyone. So that was the past. So, anyway, so when Trevor was a little kid, he was probably 6, 7 years old. He had a really bad temper. And he was a really nice kid as long as everything was going his way. But if things didn't go his way, he had a bad temper. And not only did he have a bad temper, but he had this look. And if you got him mad and he showed you this look, it was really scary. I saw that look one day and it's like, wow. Wow. Anyway, so he's playing with his friends. We moved into a new house, a new neighborhood, and there wasn't too many kids around there. So my wife went out to see who the other little kids were in the neighborhood and get them to come and play with our son. So everything went well until they got him mad the first time. And then when they got him mad the first time, they got to see how angry he could be. And so they were out playing one day, and all of a sudden, he came in after like 10 minutes. And usually when they play all the game. So 10 minutes, I knew something went wrong. And so I asked him, what's going on? And he turned and looked at me, and I knew exactly what was going on because he had that look on his face. And that look was a look of anger. And when his friends saw that, he scared them. And they went home. And I sat him down and talked with him once he calmed down a little bit and asked him, why are you upset? And he told me why. They were playing a game, and my son is very, very good in sports. And it didn't matter what sport that he played, he was good at it. He was a natural. The only problem is he didn't like to lose. Okay? My son also was very smart, so he would make up rules as he went along. You ever played with kids like that? Okay? It's not fun, is it? Okay? Now you need to realize that if you're that kid, it's not fun. And if you change the rules in the middle of the game, it's not fun for the other people, and after a while you're not going to have friends that would want to play with you. So talking with my son, I had to ask him, what got you upset? And he said, well, we were playing basketball, and this happened and that happened. And I said, what were the rules? And he said, well, this was the rule, but then they started doing this, so I changed the rules. I said, and how did they feel when you changed the rules? He goes, I don't know, I didn't ask him. I changed the rules, and this is what the rules are going to be. I had to explain to him.
Hey, John?
Yes?
I'm kind of mad at something. It's like God's like, you must be baptized. And he's like, psych, no, you don't.
So in talking with him and talking with his friends, I asked them, when you changed the rules, and when you got upset, what happened? He goes, well, they went home. And I said, did they say they were going to play with you tomorrow? No, they didn't say anything. I said, do you want to play with them tomorrow? Yeah. I said, do you think if you play with them tomorrow, and you play the same game, and you keep changing the rules, you think they're going to continue to want to play with you? He goes, well, I never thought about that. It's like, that's just one issue. Here's the other issue. I said, that look on your face that your mother and I tell you about when you get upset, you know what look I'm talking about? He goes, yeah. I said, did you have that look on your face before they left? He goes, yeah, I probably did. I said, you realize that that's, number one, it's a scary look. And your friends are not going to want to hang around you if you keep doing that. And he goes, why? He goes, I don't know what to do. I get angry and I don't know what to do with that anger. So it just comes out. I said, well, that's understandable. I said, you understand that Everyone gets angry. But we deal with it in different ways. So now God has ways, and he teaches us through his word how to deal with anger. And I said, I know you know these because you go to church school, you come to church, I've talked to you about this, do you ever use it? He goes, no, when I'm mad, the only thing I think about is how mad I am. It's like, okay, so the first thing you need to do is when you're mad, is to, number one, know that that look is on your face. So you look at the other people, and if you see them backing away from you, you need to calm down. And then you need to, if you can't talk to them nicely, you need to excuse yourself, and you're the one who needs to leave. Until you're able to come back and talk to them in a nice, friendly manner. Because if you want to have friends, you got to be friendly. Is that right? So, what happens if you're your age and you have a problem with anger and you never gain control of it and then you get to be an adult? You think that could be a very bad thing?
Therapy.
Now listen, this afternoon they're going to have a prison ministry meeting with the people that go into the jails. In my business, I hire a lot of people that are either on their way, they're on probation, or they're out on bond, and these are the kind of people I get to hire, or they're just coming out of jail, they need work. I get to deal with a lot of people who have been in and out of the prison system. And I've met a lot of people who have anger issues, and not one of them started that anger issue as an adult. It started from a child, okay? And it led them into very bad places. So if you're one of those that deal with anger, there's positive ways to deal with it. And the first thing to do is to not allow your emotions to be the thing that controls you. Scarlett, do you ever get mad at your brother and sister?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Both of them accidents. I don't know. Like, she called me fat, but I called her fat. She gets
now, listen. This is a life lesson that you need to learn for the rest of your life. Never call that to a girl. Ever. So listen, instead of doing that, instead of getting that upset where you want to get physical with it, at a certain point, you need to learn, number one, how to deal with all that anger inside. What do you think is a good way to deal with that? The first thing to do is pray. Pray that God gives you peace. And that you don't get out of control. Have you ever seen a little kid out of control? Have you ever been to Walmart at Christmas time and seen little kids out of control? Black Friday. Yes, so listen, don't be one of those little kids. Learn how to deal with these issues, learn how to deal with them positively, and learn how to talk through conflict, because that will help you the rest of your life. Okay? Can I ask you a break? Yeah, can you do it? I think you can.
Dear Jesus, thank you for today. Thank you that we can learn how to deal with anger and help us when we do get angry that we won't strike out and say mean things. And
amen.
Just be nice to the person who you're angry with. Amen.
Amen. That lesson is for all of us.